very beautiful and important seminar on information technology for hotels and restaurants. Before I begin, I'd like to invite our chairman, Mr. Shail Bharot, to please come on stage. I also like to invite our lovely speaker, Mr. Rajesh Pillai, to please accompany us. And on board, Mr. Rajesh Jalla, to please come to the stage. Mr. Ravi Jalla, to come to the stage, please. Good afternoon once again. I'm Sabio Fernandez, the Assistant Secretary General of the Hotel and Restaurant Association, Western India. Our association and I extend a very warm welcome to you all at this important information technology seminar for hotels and restaurants. Today, your association has in its 69th year, and it represents the reputed international and national chains of hotels and restaurants in the Western region, comprising the states of Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Goa, and the Union Territories of Daman, Diu, Silvassa. Your association has been in the forefront to represent on topics of current interest, not only with the government, but also among the membership fraternity of over 1,500 members. The activities of the association includes organizing of regional conventions, business seminars, and scholarship to the deserving students, and continued dialogue with the government bodies on the topic pertaining to the hospitality sector. Now I call upon our chairman, Mr. Shail Bharot, to please come on the stage and to brief us upon our theme.
Thank you, Mr. Savio. I'll just quickly introduce both our speakers for today. We've got Mr. Rajesh Pillai, who's the CEO of Treya Wireless. He's performed various functions in bringing seed funding for the company, recruiting pre-sales, sales, technical and operational teams, and has also handled finance management. Before starting his firm, he's worked for companies such as Docomo, Netmagic, Hindustan Unilever, and he's completed his master's in management studies and a bachelor in science in physics. Moving on to our dear friend, Ravish. Ravish has done his postgraduate in e-business and currently he's studying hotel planning and design from the Cornell University. He's a hospitality consultant in the field of low voltage, upscale wireless technologies, and security has been part of the startup ecosystem for almost 6 years now. Ravish has worked with Hyatt, Mars, Oberoi Hotels, Leela Palaces, and the list practically goes on and on. I won't waste much time reading out the entire list. I now request Mr. Pillai to kickstart the seminar and go ahead with his presentation.
It's not coming proper. So meanwhile, he fixes that up. Give me a show of hands, how many from restaurants, how many from hotels, so that I know what my crowd is. How many from restaurants? Only two. Baki sab hotels? Oh, fantastic. Okay. Okay, I call our generation a busy generation. We are talking about the millennials. Millennials, wo generation hai jo 24 ghanta internet pe rehta hai. I mean, that's the future of the world. This is where we are going to. Whether we are talking about hotels, restaurants, we are talking about home, we are talking about workspaces, we are talking about people continuously connected to internet. 2019 ka figures hai ye. 1 minute of internet time mein, there are 4.5 million videos being watched. Netflix, 694,444 hours of Netflix being watched. This 1 minute of internet time. The whole world is connected. Everybody is doing data. This data is going to change everything. The way we perceive business today is going to change in next 2 years, next 3 years. This is just people connected to the internet. You'll have IoT devices coming onto the network. And these devices again will generate data. that will further require security. So when you start, when you have the businesses across, is not just the restaurants or the hotels, are going to change, and it will be based on data. This is just India, okay? India is already the second largest in terms of mobile internet. India is third largest in terms of internet users. Fifth largest in terms of video users. So India is running this game. It's ahead of the most of the countries. It's going to beat China also in terms of the kind of data that's being consumed. So internet becomes a part of our daily lives. 16 hours per week on the net, 2 hours more than TV viewing. So people are not watching television, they're more on the internet. That comes to a classic topic. Why is free Wi-Fi important? Now this connected people, the millennials, who are always on the internet, wherever they go, they want that internet connection. Whether it's a restaurant, whether it's a hotel, whether it's workplace, whether it's public locations, they need this free Wi-Fi. That's how these guys get connected. And it's free Wi-Fi because internet is ubiquitous now. It's everywhere. You go to your office, you get free internet. You're at home, you are practically free internet. Okay, so they expect free internet everywhere. So free Wi-Fi is the is going to be the baseline. The geo impact. Geo has done a serious damage to the entire ecosystem of data. They've slashed down the prices. The data costs have come down. People are more on the internet nowadays. But what we see is, in a closed environment, like a building or a restaurant or a closed spaces, the geo penetration is not great. That is why Wi-Fi will stay. It's going to be there. Plus, as the density goes up, as more and more people get connected to 4G and 5G, what happens is the speeds, the experience come down. To tackle that, you still need Wi-Fi. Lot of these ISPs are offloading their data on Wi-Fi to handle these kind of problems. Okay, it's only in India that you have 4 or 5 players who are providing ISP level bandwidth on a 4G and 5G. But if you go to US and European countries, you have only 1 or 2 players. Because when you want signals to reach the lifts, the basement, you have to increase the power of the signals. It's also a health hazard. Technically speaking, it's still a health hazard. So there'll be a point where you have to stop that. You know, you can't just provide internet into the lifts and, you know, 4G into the basement. It will come down. Okay, that's where the Wi-Fi will come, will become more important. So coming to hotels and restaurants, what we see is the first 3 amenities that a hotel needs to give to the guest is a complimentary breakfast, a good restaurant, and Wi-Fi. So we have seen in hotels, so we service a lot of 5-star hotels also. So when we see 5-star hotels, guests actually check out if you don't give them good Wi-Fi. So that becomes a very critical function in a hotel environment, free Wi-Fi. So 95% of the guests consider hotel internet while booking. It is a given. But surprisingly, not too many hotels take this very seriously. They don't understand Wi-Fi can become a critical service. Actually, it has become a critical service. According to Accor, after good tea, the guest asks for a good internet connection. 80% of the guests would not book again after a bad Wi-Fi experience. 84% of hotels believe reputation for good Wi-Fi affects new and repeat business. So Wi-Fi becomes a core service to a hotel and a restaurant. Guest reviews internet more than any other service. So if you go to TripAdvisor, if your internet is not good, the first comment, a bad comment, comes for Wi-Fi. So though it's not a core business for a hotel to provide Wi-Fi, It's lodging that's their core business, but Wi-Fi becomes a critical service. So it's logical. I mean, a guest comes to a hotel for what? To work. Okay. If he comes to work, he needs internet connection, a good internet connection. Now, internet connection is not just putting up an access point, putting up bandwidth, and it starts working. No, there's a lot of guest management that falls into place. There's a lot of security that falls into place. You need to understand that it's not home Wi-Fi. You have different kind of devices coming into the hotel and getting connected to the network. That becomes a big challenge by itself. So different locations. So it's Wi-Fi is never one size fits all. Different kind of location requires different kind of Wi-Fi. If it's a five-star hotel, it becomes a critical service. As I said, the guest can walk out of the hotel if the service is not good. It has to be, the devices has to be branded, high-end. The software has to be high-end because it's policy-driven. So you should be able to give internet to different kind of people in a different level. So a high level of security, and the service is always SLA driven. So five-star hotel is a very different Wi-Fi network. Budget hotels also require good internet connection. The only problem is it's budget. So it has to be budget driven. Okay, but that doesn't mean that experience has to suffer. If it's properly designed and executed, the service can be on a good level. Not as good as a five-star hotel, but it may not run policies, but the guest coming to your hotel can be satisfied. Wi-Fi marketing. So I'm coming to the restaurants now. We have observed that people are okay with seeing advertisements, in return to free Wi-Fi. So as of now, not many restaurants are thinking on those lines. But internationally also, a lot of restaurants do monetization, where you can run ads and try to recover a bit of your cost. So we do this for CCDs. Okay, we provide Wi-Fi to CCD. It's a great to have service. If you look at my classic example, is always Starbucks. Starbucks, the prime goal is to sell coffees, but that's not what they do. They provide great internet. You see people with their laptops open and actually working at Starbucks. The internet there is running for 8 hours, and the bandwidth coming in is like 15 Mbps, 1:1 line into the hotel, into each outlet. I mean, they are actually giving out free internet in return selling coffees. So the business models have changed. That the places now CCD is trying to do that. They're trying to provide internet and sell their coffees. So that business model is coming up. So in a restaurant, you need to have a, on an average, you look at a restaurant, your network should be able to manage about 20 to 30 clients, moderate bandwidth, good analytics, because that's what would you need, you know, the kind of people coming in your restaurant. What is the duration they're sitting in your restaurant? All that information can be gathered.